हेलो एवरीवन, सो वी आर बैच नंबर 11 एंड आर टीम कंसिस्ट ऑफ आई प्रणव मटर, शिव मेजी एंड सत्यम दोडमणि. सो वी आर हियर टू गिव अ ब्रीफ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑन द टॉपिक सोशल नेटवर्किंग. सो बिफोर वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज सोशल नेटवर्किंग, वील गिव द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन. So the internet has rapidly evolved from being merely an information sharing platform to being a social networking platform used by individuals to share the content, opinions, and informations. Social networking is a global phenomenon that has revolutionized how people interact with each other. It affects nearly every aspect of our life, that is education, communication, employment, politics, healthcare, social relationships, and personal productivity. A social networking service, that is SNS, is an internet-based platform used in building and developing social relations among people. It provides means by which users can interact online with people of similar interests, whether it be for romantic or social purpose. It allows users to share emails, instant messaging, online comments, Wikipedia, digital photos and videos, along with forced blog entries. It also offers people with disabilities a chance to make their thoughts and opinions known in a virtual environment. Social networks serve a dual roles as both suppliers and consumers of content. They provide the user with a choice of who can view their profile. Profile is generated from the answers to questions such as age, location, interests, etc. Some sites allow users to upload pictures, add multimedia content, or modify the look and feel of the profile, comment on postings, compile and share list of contacts. To protect user privacy, social networks typically have controls that allows users to choose who can view their profile, contact them, add them to their list of contacts, and so on. So now we'll give you some popular social websites that are Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Google Plus. So before going into the main topic, now we'll go through what is the purpose of our application. So social networking applications have become important services that provide internet-based platform for users to interact socially. Common applications involve computer-mediated social interaction, education, business, finance, healthcare, politics, religion, and crowdsourcing. So now we'll go through the requirements for our applications. So basically, the requirements are divided into functional requirements, non-functional requirements, and external interface requirements. So firstly, we'll go to functional requirements. In the functional requirements, it requires internet connection. It requires hardware device which has web browser to access the website. And user should be able to register for a new account, should be able to log in into his account session from the system after his valid credentials are verified. When the user enters the information, the system shall send an approval request. And the server shall log all changes to existing data. And all users' data shall be stored into the database. Now we'll go through the external interface requirements. In the external interface requirements, we have hardware interface, that is an internet compatible hardware device. And the social interface includes a web browser or a Node.js server or MongoDB database and server. And in the user interface, a GUI website compatible with mobile view and desktop view. In the non-functional requirements, a database security shall meet HIPAA requirements. If user has not changed their password for 56 days, then the system shall require a password change upon login. The layout shall allow users to reach their profile data from any page within 3 clicks. So as our platform have some artifacts. So now we'll discuss the use case diagram. So as you can see in the use case diagram, we have admin and user. So user can log in or log out to the application. So when he logins to the application, he can search the content and he can organize or make new friends. So when he creates his account, he'll be having his user profile where he can edit his profile or change profile photo. And also you can view the news or the events that are happening around. Yeah, also you can also upload the photos or the videos, and you also can comment on his new friends posts that are posted on the application. And you can also provide the feedback to the admin, and you can also message or chat with his friends. So as we have built these applications, now we are the admins. So admin will be having again a new interface. So when admin log into the interface, he can manage the membership. That is, whenever a user creates his profile, so admin can differentiate a user is a valid user or not. So with a, like if the user is having multiple accounts with the same number, so this account is invalid. So the admin can look into that. And it can also manage social media content, and you can manage homepage. So, and you can also put up some news or events on the platform. So you can also keep regularly checking or updating the news and the events. In the artifacts, we can also come across the class diagram and sequence diagrams. And the further demo of the application will be explained by Mr. Satyan.
Yeah, thank you, Arvin. So let's move on to our application, how the application works and stuff. But before starting that, I would just like to go through what languages we have used to build an application. For GUI, we have used embedded JavaScript, that is famously known as EJS. And then for the server side scripting, we have used Node.js as well as Express.js. And for the database, we have used MongoDB. For this application, for now, we have used at a server, and that is a node daemon or nodemon, whatever it's called, and a server .js file. So once we run this, server gets hosted. So the server is starting, and the server is on localhost on 3000 port, and it checks if the MongoDB is connected, hence the database connected message is shown. So here we can say that our database has been connected. So before we move further to this, I would like to just show our database. And presently I have an empty database. I'll just start from the scratch, giving a user signing in, and then I'll log in. I'll show two different users on two different browsers so that we can relate and see some test cases on how it works. So let's move on, and I'll just give a localhost 3000. So this is the default page where you get without any users. It's though it has some information, but it's not logged in. So I'll just go to a sign up, and then I'll just add a user here. I'll add my name, I'll add my username, and I'll just add an email. And this is validated. If I try to register, it will ask not to leave anything blank. So the form here, form validation has been taken care of. So now I add my password and mail is checked. I'll register. So we get a message saying that signed up successfully. You can log in now. So once we log in, it'll redirect us to once we sign up, it will redirect us to the login page where we can log in using the same email and the password that we just feed it. So I'll just log in. So once we log in, the first thing it will ask is for the cover page and your profile photo. Now this is your profile information, where first whenever you sign in as newly or log in as a new user, the basic requirement that this system or this application asks. So I'll just go for adding a cover page here. So where did I save it? Yes, here they are. So I'll just add a random cover page here, and then I'll add a random profile page. So this is been updated, and I just want to check in my database if this is here. So I'll just refresh my database and check if Satyam and Dudman, yeah, this user has been created, the profile image path has been saved, the cover photo path has been saved. Now for here, as it's a local server, so everything is saved locally. The database is local, so everything is saved locally. We have even access token here, where the login or the period of where a user is logged in will be decided by this. The expiring of access token will in turn log out the session. So here we have friends, where all the friends are being saved. Then pages, notification, groups, posts, everything will be saved here. So let's move on to our application and let's just update this. We can see here there are some fields which are not filled up. So we will just go and fill up this. What we'll do is we'll add date of birth, we'll add a city name, we'll add a country. And then I'll just add about me. Once we save this, it will pop up an alert message saying that profile has been updated. And let's just can add either a video or an image. For now, I'll add an image. I'll just choose a random image here and I'll just post it. So post has been uploaded, and let's check in the database if we have got the post. Yes, we have got the post. The image has been successfully uploaded, and then we have the caption that we gave, my first post. So everything has its ID, unique ID. And here, when we post or when we look at the post of others or the friends, we can comment, we can like, we can comment, and we can even reply to the comment. We can even reply to the comment likewise. So we get this, and everything is stored inside the database here. So I'll go to the users. I'll have the comment section here. So yeah, post object, one post. We have a comment section here where we have a comment saying nice, and there is a reply where we have got thank you. Similarly, it likewise works on if we have other posts also. So then we have a search bar where we can search our friends. For now, we do not have another user. So let me create one using another browser. So I'll just go to my local host 3000. So in this, I'll even show you if you think that /profile/update profile will take us here, then what if when we are logged out, will it take us here? So we'll just check that here. So we have a logged out this user here. So what we have is update profile. So yes, it doesn't allow us there. And let me create another user here. So that will be Pranav. I'll just keep the username as Pranav. Keep the email as Pranav. So the same procedure is followed here. Once we sign up, it will take redirect us to the login page. Once we even log in this, it will ask the same thing, asking a cover photo. And I'll just add a cover photo here. It's beautiful cover photo. Yep, I'll add a. Yeah, so even here we can the same procedure is followed. We can just upload the profile thing, and then now we have another user. Let's just check and confirm that if we have another user here. Yes, we do have Pranav Mathadia. So now let's go to my old user ID and just check if we have a friend there. So Pranav, so I'll just check here. Okay, it's giving me some error. So just, yeah, I got that. I did get Pranav Mathadia. I'll just send him a request and I'll check if he got any request here. So let's go to Pranav and let's check inside this friend if he got a request. Yes, he did get a request saying from Satyam. So I can accept it and now we both are friends. So this is one of the features that this app provides. And then I just wanted to show you a case where we cannot simply go and log in. Okay, there is another thing where we get notifications if liked and if a post is liked and commented. So here we get a friend request notification, and here we get a liked notification. So once this is done, we can just log out. I'll just log out and I'll check if the update profile still works. So update profile works, but it doesn't show us the user. It doesn't show us the user and it asks us to log in or sign up here. So this is one of the use cases where redirecting using routing using a path on the link is not working once the user is locked up. So this is it. So everything is posted, everything is updated. What we can conclude is we have learned a lot on how to use these languages to build a software which is embedded JavaScript and the node and the backend scripting that is nothing but Node.js and this the other it's on a production mode, admin user also will be enabled. I mean, we will have an interface where we can monitor the post and we can monitor the content that has been updated on social media or on this applications where as it is not a good thing on cybercrime or it's not very appreciated. So it's everything can be taken care if this is once on the production mode. So for now, this is all it that we have for this application. So yep, thank you.